Good evening. My name is Iris Bonnet. I am the Academic Dean of the Harvard Kennedy School and also Director of the Women and Public Policy Program. It is with enormous pleasure that I welcome all of you tonight to this extraordinary introductory keynote speech that we will have the pleasure to listen to by Her Excellency Tawakkol Karman, the first Arab woman to receive the Nobel Peace Prize. This is the opening speech to a wonderful conference that is going to take place here at the Kennedy School tomorrow, which is called Culture, Identity, and Change in the Middle East, Insights for Conflict and Negotiation. And I'd like to recognize the three faculty co-chairs of the conference, Hannah Riley Bowles, who is an associate professor here at the Harvard Kennedy School, one of the leading thinkers on gender and negotiation, and more recently also moving into gender, culture, and negotiation with a particular focus on the Middle East. I'm also pleased to welcome May Dabagh, who is sitting right there. May is formerly from the Dubai School of Government, where she directed the Research Center on Gender in Public Policy. Currently, she is, I'm very happy to say, a fellow at the Women in Public Policy program, and soon is going to join NYU as a faculty member. May is one of the leading thinkers about gender in the Middle East, but in particular focusing on gender in negotiation and decision making. And finally, it's an enormous pleasure to welcome Michelle Gelfand. She's a professor at the University of Maryland, and she's also a leader on a large multi-university initiative focusing on, in particular, negotiation and collaboration in the Middle East. I've had the pleasure of working with all three of them, and they are just wonderful colleagues and enormously productive and important scholars. I'd also like to thank the co-sponsors of the conference, the Center for Public Leadership, who has been the primary sponsor and organizer of tonight's events and the conference. Also the Institute of Politics, organizing tonight's event, the Middle East Initiative at the Belfer Center, the Program Negotiation at the Harvard Law School, and the Women and Public Policy Program here at the Kennedy School. This conference really is a role model for us here at Harvard in terms of cross-center collaboration, cross-school collaboration, but really more importantly, and I'm sure that's why all of you are here, a role model for global collaboration with scholars really from around the world, many, many scholars from the Middle East who are here tonight, many scholars from other parts of the world. So this is just a unique opportunity for all of us to learn so much from you. Thank you for joining us tonight. Thank you for the conference that will take place this next day, tomorrow. And with that, let me turn over to Hannah Riley Bowles, who is going to introduce our guest of honor tonight.
Thank you, Iris. So I am honored this evening to introduce Her Excellency Tawakkol Karman. A journalist with a graduate degree in political science, Karman has been fighting publicly for her people's political liberty since at least 2005, when she co-founded Women Journalists Without Change.
Without chains, yes.
Not change, chains. No, chains. Chains, yes, exactly. Women journalists, let me ask you that. Women Journalists Without Chains. Absolutely, I need to articulate well, because that's a big difference. She has been dubbed, on the subject of change, she has been dubbed the Yemeni Joan of Arc. But at home, she is known as the mother of the revolution, a mother of three children herself, and a mother of what she refers to as the Yemeni Youth Peaceful Revolution. She is credited with lighting the spark of the Arab Spring in Yemen and leading the transformational peace demonstrations in what she calls Change Square. Change is a very important theme, a very important central message. In attempts to dampen her flame, she has been arrested, detained, and attacked. But her resilience has only fed her followers' fire, courage, and outrage. She and her fellow protesters camped in Change Square are credited with the removal of Yemeni dictator Ali Abdullah Saleh and with setting her country on the course to democratic rule. In 2011, she was counted among foreign policy's 100 most influential thinkers globally, the world's most 100 influential thinkers. And as you know, she was also awarded the Nobel Peace Prize for her leadership in nonviolent struggle for peace, democracy, and women's liberation. Karman dedicated her Nobel Prize to the women of Yemen and to all of those Yemenis who sought peaceful revolution, in her words, facing snipers with flowers. And to the peaceful protesters in Tunisia, Egypt, and all the Arab world. In anticipation of Her Excellency's visit, I watched a lot of YouTube videos. I wanted to see her message and watch her in action. I was actually tempted to stream some of the images of her in Change Square leading chants. Many of these videos brought tears to my eyes, and they would bring tears to yours. As I watched these videos, I was reminded of the poet Carl Sandburg's tribute to U.S. President Abraham Lincoln, a man who led our country through a painful civil war, fighting for the integrity of our democracy and for human rights. Sandburg wrote of Lincoln, "Not often in the story of mankind does a man arrive on earth who is both steel and velvet, who is as hard as rock and as soft as drifting fog, who holds in his heart and mind the paradox of terrible storm and peace unspeakable and perfect." We have the rare honor this evening to share the company of a woman who is both steel and velvet. A person who has the strength to hold in her heart and mind the paradox of terrible storm and the vision of peace unspeakable and perfect. The type of person our world needs so desperately today. Please join me in welcoming Her Excellency Tawakkol Karman.
Thank you so much. I am Tawakkol Karman, not Her Excellency. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Peace be upon you. Really, I am so proud. I am so grateful. I am so happy that I am here in Harvard University. This is my second time to be here. I was hoping that what is the time that I will study in Harvard University? But now I'm teaching. What's that? So really, I'm so proud. And also, I am so proud for coming to Harvard University with new president, which is woman. Let's greet Her Excellency Drew Faust and congratulate her to lead this, the oldest and the biggest university in the world. This is a big achievement for all women and for also men around the world, and I am sure that Harvard University under her leadership will be big and will be more effective. Now I will speak in Arabic, so allow me for that, doing that. Sayyidat al-Sada, أقف اليوم أمامكم قادمة من دول الربيع العربي. لا أزال في هذه اللحظة أشم رائحتها المليئة بعبق الأمل والتغيير الأفضل. إنني في هذه اللحظة أيضا أرى أمام عيني دماء صديقاتي زينب وتفاحة وياسمين ومريم وعزيزة، دماء أبنائي وإخواني الشباب من شهداء وجرحى ثورات الربيع العربي الذين لم يكن لهم ذنب سوى المطالبة بمستقبل أفضل ووطن يتسع للجميع يعلي قيم المواطنة المتساوية.
I stand in front of you today as one who is from the countries of the Arab Spring, and I continue to smell the full fragrance of hope and for change that will better our society. However, I still see the blood of my friends who were victims of that time, such as Zainab, Tufaha, Yasemin, Maryam, and Aziza, as well as the blood of my brothers, brother Arabs who were murdered and wounded in the Arab Spring Revolution. Their only crime was to demand a better future in their homeland for all people and their desire for equality of all citizens.
دعوني أحدثكم عن دول الربيع العربي التي طالتها الثورات منذ العام الماضي والتي ينتظرها مصير مماثل في الأعوام القادمة، إذ أن التغيير الذي تشهده المنطقة هو قدر تاريخي غلاب ليس بوسع أحد إيقافه، لأن الحق ينتصر وإن غلب الظلمة والعسفة والطغيان ساعة، ولأن نزوع الإنسان إلى الحرية والكرامة أصيل.
Let me talk to you about the countries of the Arab Spring that have been affected by revolutions over the course of the last year, as well as those who will likely undergo a similar fate in the near future. The change which the region observed was a historical effort which no one could have stopped, because justice withstood the arbitrariness and the tyranny that had been in place for many hours, and humanity was able to overcome, bring with it the freedom and dignity that is inherited in all.
هناك عوامل مشتركة بين هذه الدول كانت كلها سببا رئيسيا في تفجير ثورات الربيع العربي التي عملت على إسقاط الطغاة المستبدين الفاشلين، والتي تعمل الآن على بناء الدولة المدنية الحديثة الديمقراطية.
There are common factors among these countries which led to the igniting of a peaceful revolution that have brought down a tyrant and corrupt dictators who have failed to build modern democratic civil states.
جميع هذه الدول دول عائلية وفردية، الفساد يتكاثر فيها وفق آليات ولوائح وقوانين وتشريعات رسمية تكفل له الحماية والتمدد. أجهزتها الأمنية والعسكرية بوليسية قمعية مسخرة لخدمة فساد الرئيس وعائلته ونظامه، مسخرة لمصادرة الحقوق والحريات وممارسة مختلف أشكال التعذيب والاعتقال القسري والإخفاء القسري للمواطنين. دول تعاني شعوبها من البطالة وتفتقر لأدنى متطلبات الحياة الحرة والعيش الكريم.
All of these countries are based upon systems set up around individuals and families. The corruption inherent in them is significant and is supported by the mechanism of power. The laws in the places all set up to ensure the protection and enhance powers of the leaders. In addition, the security service and military service are also in a place to support the corrupt practice of the leader, his family, and his regime, with their mission being confiscated the rights and freedoms of the people, and practicing different forms of torture as well as arbitrary detention and the forced abduction of citizens. In these countries, people suffer from unemployment and lack of minimum requirement to live their lives in a free and respectful manner.
إن أسوأ العوامل المشتركة بين تلك الدول أن أنظمتها سعت للتوريث، بما يعنيه أن يورث الحاكم الحكم لابنه أو لأحد من عائلته. كانت البداية من سوريا حين تولى بشار الأسد الحكم بعد وفاة والده. بعدها بدأنا نسمع بجمال مبارك وبسيف الإسلام القذافي وبصخر الماطري صهر زين العابدين بالعلي وبأحمد علي عبد الله صالح.
The worst of the joint factors among the countries of the Arab Spring is they created hereditary regimes, passing power from father to son, or in some cases to others in the family. This was seen most recently in Syria, when Bashar al-Assad took over power from his father who died. After this, we began to hear about Jamal Mubarak in Egypt, Saif al-Islam al-Qaddafi in Libya, and Sakhr al-Matri in Tunisia, who is the son-in-law of Zain al-Abidin bin Ali, as well as Ahmad Ali Saleh in Yemen.
وما زاد هذا الواقع السيء سوءا ألا وجود لمعارضة سياسية حقيقية وفاعلة. هناك فشل لكافة التيارات والقوى التقليدية التي وضعت نفسها كبديل ديكوري، فالمعارضة في تلك البلدان مأمونة العواقب ومتحكم بمخرجاتها من قبل الحاكم حتى غدت جزءا منه وبعضا من آليات حمايته التي يستفيد منها في تنفيذ الاحتقانات وتأجيل الثورة الحقيقية في انتظار التغيير الزائف.
What made the situation worse was there was no real or effective political opposition. All such elements failed, and the traditional power centers, which may have been proven to be an alternative to these dictators, were incapable. The opposition in these countries was hindered, and it's oftentimes had to be led by those outside the country until they could return and bring with them mechanism for their protection, and therefore there was a delay in undertaking a real revolution.
إن هذا الواقع السيء أنتج شباباً محبطاً يعاني أزمة ثقة من الحاكم والمعارضة على حد سواء، تعوزه آليات التنظيم والتواصل ليفعل شيئاً يقلب الطاولة. ظل ذلك الوضع لعدة عقود حتى تكفلت وسائط المعلومة ووسائل الإعلام بتوفير ما كان يفتقر إليه الشباب، وهو التنظيم المرن والتواصل الذي لا يمر عبر الحاكم ولا يأخذ الإذن منه. فكانت الثورة وستستمر وتتجدد ما دام هناك حكام مستبدون، وما دام هناك دول محسوبية، وما دامت هناك وسائط للتواصل.
This made situation created frustrated people suffering from a crisis of confidence among the leadership and the opposition to a bad degree. The situation got worse for decades until information system and media improved allowed the youth a means to reach out, something they had been lacking until that time. This system then allowed for flexibility and communication, which was not permitted by the leadership, something the regime could not control. The Arab Spring will continue and will renew itself time and time again as long as there is a leaders who oppress their citizens and there are methods of a free and open communication.
خرج شباب الربيع العربي بدءا بتونس واليمن ومصر وليبيا وسوريا وهم يحملون أحلامهم بالحرية والكرامة والعدالة والمساواة والديمقراطية وسيادة القانون، ومعها ثقتهم وإيمانهم بأن إذا الشعب يوما أراد الحياة فلا بد أن يستجيب القدر. خرجوا يحملون أحلامهم وأكفانهم على أيديهم، ليس رغبة بالموت لكن بحثا عن الحياة الحرة والكريمة التي إن لم تكتب لهم فإنهم حتماً سيمنحونها لأولادهم وللأجيال من بعدهم.
The youth of the Arab Spring were initially mobilized in Tunisia, then Egypt, Yemen, Libya, and Syria. They carried with them their dreams of freedom, dignity, justice, equality, democracy, and rule of law. And among those is their confidence that people one day will also live their lives in this manner. It is without a doubt that this is achievable. They came out carrying their dreams, coffins in their hands. They did not want to die, but rather they were searching for a free life with a dignity which had not been written for them until this time. And if it's not for them, then for children or for generations to come.
لقد قرر شباب الربيع العربي أن يشعل الثورة متسلحا بالحلم والإرادة والقدرة على التضحية واليقين باستحقاق النصر. خرج شباب الربيع العربي وهو واثق ثقة كبيرة بجدوى الاعتصامات والتظاهرات، جدوى النضال السلمي الذي هو طريقه الوحيد لتحقيق أحلامه وأهدافه في إقامة دولة الحق والعدل والقانون.
The youth of the Arab Spring decided to ignite a revolution. They were armed with a dream, they will and ability to sacrifice and certainty they would succeed. The youth of the Arab Spring were mobilized and they had a great deal of confidence in working by slogans, protest and demonstration. Working in a peaceful manner was viewed as the only way to achieve their dream with the goal of creating a country based upon rights, justice and law.
خرجنا نهتف بالشوارع.
We were shouting in the streets.
سلمية سلمية. ثورتنا سلمية.
Peaceful, peaceful. Our revolution is peaceful.
خرجنا نهتف في الشوارع.
We went to the streets and we
were shouting. ثورتنا بالورود. لا رصاص لا بارود.
Our revolution is a flower. No guns, no weapons.
خرجنا نهتف في الشوارع والأزقة.
We were yelling and shouting in the alleys and the streets.
الشعب يريد إسقاط النظام.
The people want to break down the regime.
رمينا خلف ظهورنا كل مخلفات الماضي وصراعاته التي كانت نتيجة حتمية للاستبداد وسياساته القائمة على فرق تسد.
We throw behind our back all the conflict, all the past conflict, and we are just focusing on the future. And
could you repeat the last part? I'm sorry.
We throw all the differences between us.
Yeah.
Ideological. Really. Let me try my English. Yes. We went to the street. Make this big chant. People want to step down the regime. And when we go to the street, we throw all our differences. If it's religion or sector or ideology or any kind of these differences. Because we know that the dictatorship doesn't have any religion. And also, we confident that the only link between all the people and the strongest link is the link of revolution. I will reply it in Arabic. خرجنا نهتف, I will repeat it in Arabic. خرجنا نهتف في الشوارع والأزقة الشعب يريد إسقاط النظام رمينا خلف ظهورنا كل مخلفات الماضي وصراعاته التي كانت نتيجة حتمية للاستبداد وسياساته القائمة على فرق تسد مضينا غير عابئين بالروابط الإيديولوجية والمناطقية الدينية والعرقية والجنسية وغير ذلك إذ أننا مثلما نعلم أن الاستبداد لا دين له نفقه تماما أن لا رابطة أقوى وأعلى من رابطة الثورة وبشجاعة أسطورية نادرة وأمام كل العنف وسيل الدماء والدمار لم نتراجع ولم نتقهقر.
So the old regime used the old style, which is divided and rule. We didn't care about the past conflict. We continue in our struggle, and we're trying to build our nation.
بشجاعة أسطورية,
we are magnificent and courageous.
ونادرة أمام كل العنف والدمار لم نتراجع أو نتقهقر.
It's really we faced all these challenges and all these destruction, and we didn't give up and we didn't back off at all.
قررنا الاستمرار مهما كلفنا ذلك من ثمن.
And we decided to continue no matter what.
إذ أن كل شيء يهون في سبيل الحرية والكرامة.
It's everything for our freedom and for our dignity. We want to gain it back.
إذ أن كل شيء يهون في سبيل الحرية والكرامة التي حتما سنحصل عليها وقد فعلنا.
Everything we will do for our freedom and dignity and absolutely we will gain it and we are indeed gain it back.
أيتها السيدات أيها السادة.
Ladies and gentlemen.
لقد سوق الغرب نظام زين العابدين على نظام زين العابدين الفاسد على أساس أنه نموذج للحداثة.
Continue. The West pointed out the corrupt system of Ben Ali in Tunisia as an example of modernization to the world.
حتى إذا سقط حكمه تحت الضغط الشعبي تبرأ منه الغرب.
Even though it was clear that the Tunisian government worked against its people, putting pressure upon them.
في مصر تم تقديم نظام الرئيس المخلوع حسني مبارك على أنه رائد معسكر الاعتدال وأنه صاحب المصالح المؤتمنة لدول الغرب.
In Egypt, the regime of Hosni Mubarak was also presented in a similar manner, being a pioneer in the battle for modernization, and that it was in close alignment with the West, most particular the interests of the US.
لقد مثلت ثورة الربيع العربي صحوة شعوب هذه المنطقة.
The Arab Spring, it was like awakening for that region.
وكذلك مثلت صحوة مماثلة للغرب الذي لطالما ساهم في دعم الدكتاتوريات.
Also, it was awakening for the West.
إن سرعة تقديم الغرب لمشاعر المساندة وبيانات التأييد الرسمية والشعبية.
So the West was immediately aligned with the Arab through the formal statements.
I will speak in English. Do you prefer that? Huh?
Go ahead.
I have to try? Okay. I will trust myself. And try to speak in English, really. I'm sorry for that. But I came from a country who didn't learn their childhood. Country of Ali Abdullah Saleh, who didn't learn us how to speak English very well. We pay now all the price of his method in ignorance people. Make people in this country to have a lot of disease, ignorance, also wars, because that was the only way for him to keep on his chair. Dear, I came here to Harvard University to tell you that when Arab Spring decided, when Arab Youth Spring decided to step down the regime, they decided not for solving the problems inside their country. No, they decided to solve the problems around the world. Because these dictatorships is the resource of all unstable around the world. This dictatorship is the resource of spreading the hate feelings between nations, between people, between West and East. We decided to make this great revolution, and we pay a lot for that. A lot of blood. For what? For the value that all of us care, carrying. Dignity, freedom, democracy, equal citizenship, transparency, accountability, rule of law. And when we decided to do that, you respond to us that we are with you. We listened to all your support and advocacy with us. The West, the East, the West was with us, special when we fired the Tunisian revolution and also Egypt revolution, Libya also. Yemen, it was somehow, but with Syria, there is many obstacles, and until now, the West doesn't make their effort very well. I need someone to help me in translation, please. You will? Please. No, no, I have to, huh? Speak in Arabic? And you will translate? Huh? Okay. In the Surah Al-Taqdeem Al-Gharb. Yeah, please.
But you have to bear with me because I'm just going to do it. يعني خليك صبورة معاي لأن بسوي لايف ف.
Yeah, live. Okay.
Okay, فبس بطئ شوي.
But I want the soul of my speech to reach to the people. Again. إن سرعة تقديم الغرب لمشاعر المساندة وبيانات التأييد الرسمية والشعبية هنا وهناك.
The West's speed in translating their support here and there to the revolutions in the Arab world.
وإن كانت بنسب متفاوتة لكل ثورة وتسليطه الأضواء عبر إعلامه الحر على تفاصيل التضحيات والقمع.
Even though the intensity and the frequency varied from between one revolution and the other through the different media outlets.
ورصد منظماته الحقوقية للجرائم التي ترتكبها الأنظمة المستبدة.
And through the legal and human rights organizations against the crimes that were being committed by the tyrannical regimes.
ومطالبتها بالملاحقة وضغطها على حكوماتها بالوقوف مع شعوب الربيع العربي. إن ذلك جعل الغرب يقف مع مسؤوليته الأخلاقية تجاه نصرة الشعوب.
And demanding legal action be taken against the tyrannical leaders. Can you repeat the last part, please?
إن ذلك جعل الغرب يقف مع مسؤولياته الأخلاقية تجاه مساندة الشعوب.
That forced the West to adopt and assume the responsibility, the moral and ethical responsibility of supporting the Arab revolutions and the Arab people against the regimes.
تبقى المساندة الغربية المتوفرة حتى الآن غير كافية.
The Western support for the Arab revolutions until today is still insufficient.
وأقل من المتوقع.
And less than anticipated or expected.
من دول حرة تعلي من قيم حقوق الإنسان ويفترض أن تقيم مواقفها وعلاقتها بالأنظمة تبعاً لمواقفها من احترام حقوق الإنسان وكفالة حريات الباطن.
From free and fair countries who advocate human rights and equality and support and should support the equal rights and human rights in the Arab world.
إن أسوأ ما قد ترتكبه الأنظمة الغربية وفي مقدمتها الولايات المتحدة الأمريكية تجاه الثورات السلمية التي تستهدف إسقاط أنظمتها الفاسدة هي تقديم العون والمساندة نتيجة لاعتبارات أمنية ونتيجة لاتفاقات مكافحة الإرهاب.
The worst that the US government can do in terms of the Arab revolutions is support Arab governments from the standpoint, from a security and political standpoint, and due to previous agreements and obligations.
مع أنظمة تبين يقينا أنها المصدر الأول للإرهاب. والحاضن الأساسي له.
Especially with governments which it has been proven who are the number one supporters and incubators and supporters of terrorism.
دعوني أكون أكثر وضوحا.
Allow me to be even more explicit.
بأن المساندة والتدخل الخارجي لمناصرة ثورات الربيع العربي وكل الشعوب المتطلعة للحرية والكرامة.
Foreign support for governments in the region. A foreign support for governments against the revolutions in the region.
مطلوب وإجراء إنساني رشيد.
مرفوض.
مطلوب. أمر مطلوب وإجراء إنساني رشيد.
Okay. It's the other way. Okay. So the support.
Again.
Support for revolutions against tyrannical regime is necessary and important.
هي مساندة تبدأ بقطع العلاقات مع الأنظمة المستبدة تبدأ بقطع العلاقات مع الأنظمة المستبدة بالتوازي مع الاعتراف بالثورة.
Such support begins by severing relationships with these governments, severing diplomatic relationships and support, and acknowledging these revolutions.
No.
Acknowledging these revolutions.
Again. دعوني أكثر أكون أكثر وضوحا بأن المساندة والتدخل الخارجي. Come here. دعوني أكون أكثر وضوحا بأن المساندة والتدخل الخارجي لمناصرة ثورات الربيع العربي وكل الشعوب المتطلعة للحرية والكرامة أمر مطلوب وإجراء إنساني رشيد.
Okay, allow me to be more explicit. The support and foreign intervention to support the Arab Spring revolutions and all the people who aspire to freedom, dignity and democracy is demanded and is a humanitarian intervention that is righteous and necessary.
هي مساندة تبدأ بقطع العلاقات مع الأنظمة الفاسدة والمستبدة.
This support begins by severing the relationships with tyrannical and corrupt political regimes.
بالتوازي مع الاعتراف بالثورة وقواها.
While simultaneously acknowledging and accepting the strength, these revolutions and their strength.
وتقديم كافة الدعم السياسي واللوجستي لها.
And providing all the necessary political and logistical support for the revolutions.
ولا يتوقف عند توفير المناطق العازلة لحماية المدنيين والممرات الآمنة لإيصال المساعدات لهم.
Support does not end by providing safe havens, isolated safe havens for the civilians, or by allowing safe passage for support and ammunition.
وهو أعلى دعم ومساندة نطالب بها وقد لا نلجأ إليها إلا في تلك الثورة التي تبتلى بنظام قمعي وحشي كنظام بشار الأسد.
This is the most important type of support that we ask for, and we would not resort to it, a demand only in the case where only in the case of facing regimes that are tyrannical and barbaric, such as Bashar al-Assad's regime.
هي أشكال من الدعم والمساندة كلها سلمية. لا يتم فيها استخدام القوة إلا في إضيق الحدود لإسقاط النظام وضرب قواه العسكرية والأمنية.
All these forms of support are all peaceful, and we do not ask that there be the use of force unless it's in the limited situation of resorting to toppling the regime and attacking its security and military apparatus.
هي أشكال من الدعم لمنع الاعتداء على الآمنين. أشكال من الدعم لمنع الاعتداء على الآمنين إن ذهب النظام الفاسد والفاشل في الاعتداء عليهم في تلك المناطق العازلة.
We ask for such support to protect civilians if and only if the government's military attacks them in these isolated areas.
على ذلك فيجب أن يترك لقوى الثورة السلمية أن تستكمل خوض معركة التحرر السلمية.
Without such exceptions, these peaceful revolutions should be allowed to continue peacefully.
مهما كلفها الأمر من تضحيات.
Regardless of how much sacrifice this may involve.
إن مثل هذا الإجراء من شأنه أن يحافظ على سلمية الثورة ويحول دون اندلاع الحرب الأهلية أو الصراع الطائفي.
Such procedures will allow for these revolutions to continue peacefully and prevent the outbreak of civil war and sectarian strife.
وهو إجراء يساهم في حماية السلام والاستقرار العالمي مثلما يعد استجابة للضمير الإنساني.
This procedure both ensures peace and international stability and the humanitarian response to such crises in the region.
ذلكم أن نصرة الشعوب المقهورة والمقموعة واجب على كل الدول والروابط والإحلاف الإقليمية والدولية.
Supporting the revolutions and المقهورة and suppressed and oppressed populations is a responsibility that is a responsibility of each country, each organization, network, regional and international networks and organizations.
إن نصرة المظلوم هي جوهر عملية السلام.
Supporting the oppressed is at the heart of the peace process.
إذ لا سلام دون عدالة.
There is no peace without justice.
والسلام بين الدول لا يقل أهمية على عن السلام داخل الدول.
Peace between countries is no less important than peace within the countries.
إن حرب المستبدين على شعوبهم تستدعي موقفا إنسانيا عالميا عالميا مساندا لا يعبأ بمسميات السيادة الوطنية وليس مرهونا بمقررات أممية أو إجماع عالمي.
Tyrants' war against their own people requires an international humanitarian effort that is equal in importance to the importance of national sovereignty and is not hindered or restricted by international regulations or international agreements.
أيتها السيدات أيها السادة.
Ladies and gentlemen.
يمكن القول أن ما بعد الثورة هي دولة الشراكة والتعددية وسيادة القانون والمواطنة المتساوية لا الدولة الدينية ولا الطائفية ولا دولة الفرد ولا الحزب الواحد.
It is safe to say that following these revolutions, we call for a country of partnership, a country of plurality, rule of law, citizenship, equality, not a country of religion, sectarianism, or family rule and law.
لا مكان للخوف من الصراعات الثورية وتحولها إلى صراع واقتتال عنيف طالما أن الحالة السلمية للثورة باقية وطالما أن الحالة السلمية للثورة هي من أسقطت الحاكم وهي الكفيلة في نزع جميع الصراعات والاختلافات في إطار التنوع والتعدد المحكوم بالشراكة والتنافس السلمي.
There is no need to fear that these revolutions will result in an outbreak of violence and civil unrest, as long as they started peacefully and will depend in their struggle on peace and on peaceful means.
إن الشراكة الشعبية التي أشعلها الشباب وضحوا لأجلها ودفعوا بكافة المكونات الشعبية للانخراط فيها إنها وفي وقت قياسي إن هذه الشراكة القائمة على التعاون في ظل تلك الظروف من شأنها أن تقدم الحلول لكافة الإشكالات وفي مقدمتها إشكالية الإرهاب.
The partnership, the social partnership within these revolutions that were started by the youth, in which they sacrificed all that they had owned, has proven that this broad social partnership was capable of bringing down dictatorships.
لن يكون هناك
لحظة شوي. مشينا ترك الروح وقائمة على الشركة وتعاون في ظروف غير مؤدية. It is this spirit, the spirit of the youth and the spirit of the partnership that he was capable of bringing down the revolution is also capable of sustaining development and sustaining political stability.
لن يكون هناك تنظيمات إرهابية تستولي على البلاد أو تخلف الدكتاتور.
Okay. These revolutions are also capable of fighting terrorism. Following the removal of the dictator's regime, there will not be these revolutions will be able to contain terrorism.
إن المخاوف من الإرهاب غير صحيحة.
The fear of terrorism is misplaced.
الإرهاب والاستبداد وجهان لعملة واحدة.
Terrorism and tyranny are faces of the are two faces of a similar coin.
Okay. الإرهاب والاستبداد وجهان لعملة واحدة.
Terrorism and tyranny are two sides of a similar coin.
يجمع الإرهابي بالدكتاتور مصالح استراتيجية. يغذي كل منهما الآخر ويستمد منه أساليب القوة والبقاء.
Terrorists and tyrants share a similar goal, which is strategic interests, and they both feed off each other's strength.
أيها الأعزاء، إن الإنسانية قادرة على تصحيح مساراتها.
Dear guests, humanity is capable of fixing its path.
هكذا أثبت التاريخ في ألمانيا النازية.
History has proven this in Nazi Germany.
وأثبته في اعتدال حركة الحقوق المدنية.
And it proved it with the moderation of the civil rights movement.
هنا في أمريكا القائمة على مقتضيات العدل وحقوق الإنسان.
Here in the US that's based on equality and human rights.
القائمة على حقوق الإنسان غير المشروطة بلونه أو عرقه.
Based on human rights and dignity regardless of race or color.
لقد رأينا انتصارات الإنسانية الباهرة في جنوب أفريقيا ورأينا انحسار حكم العسكر في أمريكا اللاتينية.
We have seen amazing human rights developments in South Africa.
وانحسار حكم العسكر في أمريكا اللاتينية.
And a reduction of military rule in Latin America.
وها نحن نرى هذه الموجة العاتية من ثورات الشعوب في منطقتنا لتصحيح مسارنا الوطني والسياسي.
And here we see a ferocious wave in the Arab world to rectify our national and political path.
ويكفينا أن ننظر للمذابح في سوريا لندرك عظم وحجم الثمن الذي تدفعه الشعوب من أجل حريتها وكرامتها.
It is enough to see the massacres in Syria to realize the gravity and the size of the sacrifice that nations have to give up for dignity and integrity.
أيتها السيدات أيها السادة لا أريد أن أبدو كواعظة.
Ladies and gentlemen, I don't want to sound like a preacher.
أنا شديدة الرجاء وعظيمة الأمل بأن تخرج هذه الأجيال الشابة بالمعرفة من أعرق الجامعات في العالم لكي تحلق بالخير والجمال والحق.
But I'm highly hopeful that these young generations will graduate from highly esteemed educational organizations so they can win الحق آخر شيء. So they can soar with freedom and dignity and righteousness.
الحياة والحرية والديمقراطية وكل تلك المبادئ غير قابلة للتجزئة.
Life, dignity, freedom and democracy are all principles that are not subject to separation.
اطلبوها لأنفسكم وللإنسانية جمعاء.
Call for them for yourself and for humanity.
إن هذا الكوكب قريتنا الصغيرة وطننا الذي يجمعنا هذا.
This planet is our tiny village and the nation that unites us.
يحتاج إلى أسلحة أقل غطرسة وطغيانا.
Is in desperate needs of weapon that are less aggressive and tyrannical.
إنه يحتاج الحب. إنه يحتاج السلام. إنه يحتاج أن يكون خالي من كل دكتاتور فاسد ومستبد وفاشل.
It is in desperate need of love and peace and to do without all the dictators that are corrupt and tyrannical and
فاشل
and corrupt, fasid.
Thank you so much.
Wow. Sorry, I have
we might need your assistance, so if I don't know what is her name, you know?
I don't know. I just know her.
To the beautiful and inspirational interpreter who is facilitating this event, would you continue to help us? here in the forum, so I will facilitate question and answers now. In the forum here, we have three rules. All questioners must identify themselves, and you can come forward to, there are four mics here, two down on the ground floor and two up in the stairs. Our second rule is one brief question per person. No speeches. And we thirdly remind you all that questions end with question marks. So we want real questions. While people make themselves tear to the mics, I have been granted permission to ask the first question. And I want to go back to my introduction. I think you can see vividly why she would be referred to as the mother of the revolution. You have been an extraordinary inspiration to the youth in Yemen. And I want to ask, what is your message to the youth here in the United States with regard to how they can better the world that they will be sharing with your youth? Yes, come on, if you don't mind, I think you and I can.
Yeah, okay. رسالتي للشباب ولجميع الشعوب المتطلعة للحرية والكرامة.
My message to youth and to all peoples who look to dignity and liberty.
رسالتي للشباب خاصة في دول الغرب.
My message to youth, especially in the West.
بأن حرية الشعوب التي تعاني من الدكتاتوريات هي شأنكم الخاص.
That the freedom of populations that suffer under tyrannical regimes is your personal responsibility.
لا تستطيع أن تقول أن هذا شأن لا يعنينا.
You can't say that this is an issue that does not concern us.
هو شأن يعنيكم.
It is an issue that concerns you.
لأن كل تلك الدكتاتوريات كانت مصدر إقلاق لأمن العالم بأكمله.
Because all those dictatorships were a source of instability to the world in general.
أنا أقول لكل الشباب وخاصة في الغرب.
I say to all youth, especially in the West.
لا تستطيعوا أن تستمروا في النظر إلى نساء سوريا يقتلن بشكل يومي.
You can't keep witnessing the women in Syria being killed on a daily basis.
ولا لأطفال سوريا يذبحوا بشكل يومي.
And you can't keep witnessing the children of Syria being killed on a daily basis.
فيما أن الحل بأيديكم.
When the solutions are in your hand.
نعم الحل في أيديكم.
Yes, the solutions are in your hand.
تستطيعوا الضغط على حكوماتكم بأن يكون دعمهم للشعب السوري وحمايتهم للشعب السوري حماية حقيقية تتجاوز الخطب والبيانات الشديدة.
You can pressure your governments. You can pressure your governments. You can pressure your governments for their intervention in Syria to be real and effective and to go beyond just general statements and political announcements.
أقول للشباب في جامعة هارفارد بعد سنة ونصف من القتل والمذابح اليومية.
I say to youth and students at Harvard University after a year and a half of massacres and deaths
في سوريا.
In Syria.
سمعنا الولايات المتحدة الأمريكية وتبعها بقية دول الغرب يقوم بطرد السفير السوري بعد سنة ونصف من المذابح.
After a year and a half, we heard that the U.S. that the Syrian ambassador has been kicked out, and only then did other nations follow suit.
لماذا التأخر في مساندة الشعب السوري؟
Why all the delay in the support of the Syrian people?
Can you ask your government?
Can you ask your government?
أطالبكم بالضغط على حكوماتكم وعلى برلماناتكم بأن يعملوا على إقامة المنطقة العازلة لحماية الشعب السوري.
I call on you to pressure your governments and pressure your parliaments to establish safe havens for civilians in Syria.
لإقامة الطرق الآمنة التي توصل المساعدات إلى شعب سوريا.
To establish safe passages and routes to provide humanitarian aid to Syrians.
لأن تكون هناك عقوبات اقتصادية حقيقية ضد نظام بشار الأسد.
For there to be true economic sanctions against Bashar al-Assad's regime.
لأن تطرح الآن اسمه، لأن يضع اسمه الآن ضمن لائحة الملاحقين في المحكمة الجنائية الدولية.
For his name to now be included within the International Criminal Courts.
للاعتراف بالمجلس الوطني. كممثل شرعي وحيد.
To acknowledge the National Transition Council as the only legitimate authority in Syria.
لدعم شباب الثورة داخل سوريا.
To support the youth of the revolution within Syria.
لا تقولوا أنكم لا تستطيعون.
Don't say that there's nothing you can do.
لأن الشباب في أعماركم استطاعوا أن يسقطوا علي عبد الله صالح ومبارك والقذافي وبن علي وبشار الأسد في الطريق.
Because youth of your similar age were capable of deposing Ali Abdullah Saleh, Hosni Mubarak, Zain al-Abidin bin Ali, and hopefully Bashar al-Assad along in the near future.
I tell the youth in the West, message from the youth from East, that we can work together and we can build this world together. We need each other.
Hi, my name is Jenny. I'm a rising junior studying government at Harvard College. My question is, some experts say that Libya's upcoming election in June is a great success, or will be a great success. What advice do you have for the Egyptian elections, which some say have been riddled with corruption and just have not been successful?
يقول بعض المختصين بأن الانتخابات المقبلة في شهر يونيو التي ستأخذ مجراها في ليبيا ستكون ناجحة جدا فما النصائح التي ممكن أن توفريها للثوريين في مصر حتى يتم تحقيق النجاحات في الانتخابات بعد أن كانت الانتخابات المصرية أقل نجاحا بعض الشيء
عليهم أن يبقوا بفعلهم الثوري لأن الثورة لم تنتهي بعد.
They need to continue. They need to continue within the path of the revolution, the revolutionary path, because the revolution has not ended yet.
عليهم أن يعلموا بأنهم هم القوة الضامنة الوحيدة لتحقيق الدولة المدنية الحديثة، لتحقيق أهداف الثورة ومن ثم تحقيق الدولة المدنية الحديثة.
They need to know that they're the only guaranteed power that can ensure the success of the revolution and then ensure the transition to a true civil democratic nation.
عليهم أن يعملوا من أجل تجميع أنفسهم أكثر في إطار يجمعهم ويمثل يقوم على تمثيل الثورة يعني أحسن تمثيل ويستطيع أن يخوض الانتخابات القادمة بكفاءة واقتدار.
They need to work more effectively in order to frame their political activism and their they need to work within political more aggressive political parties to be able to lobby and to be able to run a more effective election campaign to be more successful within the next elections.
لقد نجحوا في ثورتهم وعليهم أن يثقوا أيضا بأنهم سينجحوا في دولتهم المدنية التي سيبنونها.
They were successful in the revolution and they need to have faith that they can continue that success and translate that success into a democratic nation.
Yes.
Thank you.
Welcome.
Hi, Mark Tomizawa. Thank you for being here. Thank you for reminding us that all people and all nations face common challenges where periodically they have to get it right again. There are older people who are now working with younger people to create effective models where more productive, concrete things get done every day. And people feel that we can use the internet to share these ideas with each other without anyone being in physical danger. The stories can be shared. When this group starts to come together more, would you be willing to advise it?
هناك عناصر من الأجيال الأكبر والأجيال الأقدم تعمل مع الأجيال الشابة لتحقيق النجاحات في ظل هذه الثورات. فهناك من يقول أن ممكن أن يتم استخدام الإنترنت لنجاح مثل هذه العملية بعيد عن مخاطر العمل السياسي والعمل الأمني المباشر فإن تم مثل هذه البوادر هل بإمكانك المساهمة فيها؟
طبعاً I'm ready. Is this a question? Is this the...
That was the question.
Yeah.
And I'll give you a card afterwards, okay?
Okay,
I'm ready.
All right, let's move to it. Yeah.
رجعت لي ناشطة سورية شكرا رجعت لي Syrian activist thank you very much for supporting Syrian revolution شكرا كتير لدعمك للثورة السورية سؤالي من قسمين my question is two parts what can we do to put pressure on Asma al-Assad and Bashar's mother to pressure him to step down شو ممكن نعمل كنساء لحتى نضغط على اسماء الأسد وأمه لبشار منشان تخليه يستقيل يتنحى عن الحكم And what's your message for Syrian women in supporting the Syrian revolution or their movement in Syria? شو رسالتك للنساء السوريات في حركتهم بسوريا؟
نفس الضغط المطلوب الذي تحدثنا عنه بضرورة إقامة المنطقة العازلة الآن لحماية الشعب السوري.
It's the same kind of pressure that we've been talking about, to demand immediately the establishment of safe havens for Syrian civilians.
وتوفير الطرق الآمنة لإيصال المساعدات إليهم.
And to provide safe routes and passages to provide humanitarian relief.
لوضع بشار الأسد وكل نظامه أفراد نظامه الذين يقتلون الأطفال والشباب والنساء لوضعهم ضمن لائحة مجرمي ضد الإنسانية ومجرمي الحرب الذين يجب أن تلاحقهم محكمة الجناية الدولية.
To put Bashar al-Assad and government officials who have been engaging in these war crimes on the list of war criminals and the list of those that are being sought by the war crimes tribunal.
Asma al-Assad تعتبر مشاركة في الجرم إن لم توقفه.
Asma al-Assad is considered an accomplice in the crimes if she does not actively try to stop them.
لنساء سوريا لقد ضربتم أروع الأمثلة في التضحية وقد ضربتم أروع الأمثلة في القوة والقيادة شكرا لكنا ولن نخذلكنا ونحن سنظل معكنا You are not alone.
Syrian women have been great examples of sacrifice and strife, and we will not let you down, and we will not abandon you. We will support you, and we will stand by you.
Yeah, Jay Livingston, do you think that Obama's increasing killer drone attacks in southern Lebanon, Yemen, are helpful to advancing the goals and principles of your revolution?
هل أترجم؟ هل تعتقدين بأن استراتيجية الرئيس أوباما باستخدام الطائرات العسكرية من غير طيار المعروفة بالدرونز فعالة في مساندة ثورتكم؟
بالطبع لا. Of course no.
Absolutely not.
طائرات بدون طيار هي لا تقتل القاعدة، هي تقتل الأبرياء من النساء والشباب والأطفال. تقتل المدنيين أولا.
The drones don't remove members of Al-Qaeda. The drones kill women, children, and mostly target civilians.
That's something we can do here too, isn't it?
لكن يعلم أوباما ويعلم جهاز استخباراته CIA بأن الحليف الأول للقاعدة هو علي عبد الله صالح وهو أسرة علي عبد الله صالح.
But President Obama and the CIA are well aware that Al-Qaeda's main supporter was President علي عبد الله صالح and his family.
وإذا لا تعلم CIA هذا الخبر فذلك معناه أنها أضعف مما نتوقع.
And if the CIA was not aware of that reality then unfortunately they are much weaker than we think.
نحن الآن الشعب اليمني أقام ثورته الشبابية الشعبية السلمية أقامها من أجل قيم الحرية والعدالة والديمقراطية ومن أجل مكافحة الإرهاب.
We the Yemeni people launched our youth popular peaceful revolution for the sake of equality, liberty, democracy and counter-terrorism.
الإرهاب قتل اليمنيين وأضرهم دمر اقتصادهم وأساء بسمعتهم.
Terrorism has killed Yemenis, has destroyed the economy, has ruined the reputation.
الإرهاب أطال بعمر الطاغية علي عبد الله صالح.
Terrorism has only prolonged the life and rule of علي عبد الله صالح.
المستفيد الوحيد من محاربة الإرهاب هو الشعب اليمني الذي مصلحته قائمة على أن تقوم بلده على أساس متين من السلم والعمل المشترك.
The only beneficiary from effective counter-terrorism efforts is the Yemeni population.
وقد أثبت الشعب اليمني ذلك.
Who has proven that its development is dependent heavily on safety and security and stability within Yemen.
الثورة السلمية استطاعت أن تسقط وأن تخفت صوت الإرهاب.
The peaceful revolution was successful in silencing and eliminating the voice of terrorism.
استطاعت أن تخفت صوت الإرهاب, صوت الأحزمة الناسفة والبارود, وأن تعلي فقط من أصوات الهتافات والمظاهرات والاعتصامات.
It was successful in silencing the calls of terrorism and the effects of the IEDs and improvised explosive device, and made loud and effective the calls for the peaceful calls for a revolution.
الثورة السلمية حاربت الإرهاب كفكر, وهذا أشد وأخطر. حاربته كفكر قبل الممارسة.
The peaceful revolution countered terrorism as an ideology, not just as a tactic.
حينما كانت الإرهاب, حينما كان القاعدة تستقطب الشباب اللي أعمارهم من 17 إلى 25 سنة ليكونوا مشاريع انتحاريين وأحزمة ناسفة, استطاعت أن تجمعهم الثورة لكي يسقطوا نظام الطاغية.
The revolution was successful in reining in the youth that were being recruited by Al-Qaeda, especially the youth that were between the ages of 17 and 25. The revolution succeeded in bringing them into the revolution and fighting to topple the regime in a peaceful manner.
واستطاعت أن تسقط إيمان هؤلاء الشباب بأن العنف طريق وسيلة وحيدة للتغيير.
It was also successful in changing the view of these youth who thought in the past that violence was the only way to change.
الآن بعد إسقاط الدكتاتوريات الخمس أصبح القناعة لدى كثير من الشباب الغالبية العظمى بأن الوسيلة الوحيدة الآن لنيل الحقوق والحريات هي السلم والسلم فقط.
Following the toppling of the five dictators, youth are now convinced that peace is a way and the only way to a successful revolution and not violence.
من جهة أخرى, نحن الآن لدينا رئيس جديد, رئيس انتقالي جديد.
On another hand, we now have a new transitional president.
الرئيس الانتقالي الجديد الآن يقود حرب حقيقية ضد القاعدة.
Our new leader now is engaged in a true war against Al-Qaeda.
وأثبت لأمريكا وللغرب أنه كم كان مغررا به.
And he has proven to the US and to the West how much they were tricked and
خلال ثلاثة أشهر بدأت القاعدة تبدأ بالانحسار وبالانتهاء.
Within only the span of 3 months, Al-Qaeda has been much less effective than it was before.
والآن تم استعادة كثير من المناطق التي أخذتها القاعدة في محافظة أبيان.
A lot of the areas within the governorate of Evian have been reclaimed by the government, those that were sieged by Al-Qaeda.
الخلاصة بأن من سيحارب القاعدة هم الشعب اليمني العظيم.
In conclusion, those who will fight Al-Qaeda is the great people of Yemen.
وأننا نرحب بالشراكة مع الولايات المتحدة الأمريكية ومع الغرب من أجل محاربة القاعدة التي زرعها علي عبد الله صالح في اليمن ليبتزكم.
And we welcome a partnership with the US and with the West to counter Al-Qaeda in Yemen, Al-Qaeda that has been working as a handmaiden of Ali Abdullah Saleh's regime.
لكن by Yemenis.
But for the fight to be by Yemenis. Yeah.
We have time for only one more question, but I cannot let you go without speaking to your work for women. And you have done so much for women through your actions and through your example. But it is interesting, when I've seen you in multiple interviews, asked if you are a women's rights advocate, you describe yourself as a humanist. And I like to ask you, as a humanist, what is the importance of women's liberation for peace and democracy?
Good question. I like this question. To all the women, all women around the world, you have to be human, not just woman. المرأة حين تقوم بدورها كإنسان في الدفاع عن الحقوق والحريات وفي مكافحة الفساد وفي بناء الدولة المدنية الحديثة حينها تكون قد انتصرت لحقوقها أولاً.
Women, when they assume their obligation and responsibility as humans in general to fight for rights and liberty and the establishment of a modern democratic righteous nation, only then do they serve their cause as women.
من تجربة شخصية.
From a personal experience.
قبل ثورات الربيع العربي كان كثير هناك من الأصوات التي تتحدث عن حقوق المرأة حقوق المرأة. المرأة يجب أن تدخل في الشأن العام. المرأة يجب أن تأخذ عدد المقاعد في البرلمان. المرأة يجب أن تأخذ الوظيفة العامة وهكذا. حقوق المرأة كشعارات.
Prior to the Arab Spring revolutions, there was a lot of talk about the need for women's rights and the need for women's participation, for women to be more active in political work, for women to be more active in parliament. So there was a lot of talk about the need for women to be more represented more effectively within a political.
كانت كلها حقوق. Asking, please give me gift. كانت مجرد سؤال واستجداء لهبة معينة من قبل الحاكم بين قوسين الرجل.
It was always beseeching and asking and imploring a specific person or a specific leader within the governmental organization.
I decided to don't ask anybody to give me my rights. We decided to take our rights by going to the street, do demonstrations, sitting, sacrificing, leading the men, and then we will give men their rights, and then we will say, okay, we have our rights. So to all women, please struggle for giving men their rights. Yeah. I was alone in the street. By the way, I don't like to speak about myself a lot, but they told me when you speak with West, you have to tell them about your story. So I will do that. I was alone in the street with my assistant Bushra, my great friend, and other assistant Afrah. We were just three women, and there is a lot of men seeing to us. We decided to fight for the human rights. We decided for sacrificing and paying all things that we can pay for giving the rights to the people who came to our organization, Women Journalists Without Chains. The first sit-in that we make was in front of cabinet. We call the square Freedom Square. It was in 2007. كان في عام 2007. بعد إنشاءنا لمنظمة صحفيات بلا قيود.
This was in 2007 after we had established our organization.
منظمة صحفيات بلا قيود حين أنشئت من أجل الدفاع عن الحقوق والحريات وفي مقدمتها الحريات الديمقراطية.
When we established the organization, Journalists Without Change, it was
without chains.
Without chains, yeah.
Yeah.
Without chains. Is that not what I said?
Yeah,
without chains. Yeah. It was for the sole purpose of advocating democracy, freedom of speech, and equality.
قررنا عن الدفاع عن جميع الصحفيين، مش الصحفيات، هي اسمها صحفيات بلا قيود. قررنا أن تكون دفاع عن جميع الصحفيين والصحفيات من أجل حقهم وحقنا وحق المواطن في حرية التعبير.
This was to defend female journalists, male journalists, all journalists. To defend their right to freedom of expression and the right of the Yemeni population.
وفي 2007 حين بدأت الانتهاكات تكبر بحق الصحفيين والصحفيات وبحق المجتمع اليمني بأكمله قررنا أن ندافع عن الحقوق والحريات ليس بإصدار البيانات والبلاغات الصحفية لكن بتأسيس الاعتصامات والتظاهرات.
And in 2007, when violations against both female male journalists and Yemeni and the Yemeni population in general with regards to freedom of speech had reached a height, we decided to up our activism by engaging in demonstrations and protests and not just using journalism.
بدأنا مجموعة من النساء في أول يوم استجابت لدينا لأن مجموعة من النساء ثم اختفين.
We got great response at the beginning from a number of women who engaged in these protests and then after a while they disappeared.
لم نتوقف. قررنا أن يكون يوم الثلاثاء هذا هو الاعتصام الأسبوعي الذي فيه سنستعيد اليمن الجديد وليس فقط الحقوق والحريات المصادرة.
Regardless, we refused to desist. Every Tuesday, we showed up and there was a protest every Tuesday and we decided that that was going to be the path to establish the new free Yemen.
كنا وحدنا ثلاث نساء فقط مع مجموعة من ضحايا الانتهاكات الذين أغلبهم رجال حين كانوا يأتون إلى مؤسستنا.
At the time, we were only three women, in addition to a number of men who were victims of the crackdown on freedom of expression.
كنا نذهب بشكل أسبوعي، لم نكل ولم نمل ولم نستسلم كل ثلاثاء ونحن أمام رئاسة الوزراء.
We used to show up on a weekly basis. We would not desist. We would not get bored, and we would not lose hope. Every Tuesday, we would show up at the presidential palace.
تعرضنا لمختلف أنواع القمع داخل الساحة.
We were subject to different forms of abuse within the premises of the presidential palace.
كنت حين أحمل الميكروفون كان هناك من يسخر مني. امرأة تحمل الميكروفون وتصرخ وتهتف بالشعارات. وهتف يعني بعدها الرجال هذه تكسر العادات وتكسر التقاليد.
When I used to pick up the microphone, I used to be made fun of. A woman picking up a microphone and speaking loudly while men chant in response behind her. This is something that goes against our cultural and traditional norms.
كانت بشرى الوحيدة التي تصور داخل ساحة الحرية.
Bushra was the only one who used to take pictures within the premises of the presidential
palace. وكانت المصدر الوحيد لنقل المعلومة إلى العالم.
And she was the only source that was transferring the information and the news to the world.
تعرضت للاعتداء ولصب الأسيد على ظهرها أثناء قيامها بالتصوير لكي تمنع من نقل المعلومة إلى العالم.
She was the subject to abuse and she suffered an attack by acid that was poured on her back.
كنت لوحدي في ذلك اليوم تم اعتقالي.
At that time, I was alone, and I was arrested on that day.
خرجت من المعتقل وخرجت بشرى من المستشفى إلى الشارع لنهتف بأننا نبحث عن الحرية والعدالة والديمقراطية.
I left the detention center, and Bushra left the hospital, and we returned back to the square where we continued chanting that we demand a free and freedom and equality.
كنا وحدنا. كنا كذلك وحدنا مرة أخرى في الشارع. هذا كله قبل ثورة الربيع العربي، قبل الخامس الأربعة عشر من يناير.
Again, here we were alone, and this was all prior to the Arab Spring and prior to January 14.
كنا نحدث أنفسنا متى سيأتي اليوم الذي ستخرج فيه المرأة اليمنية لتكسر القيود ولتدافع عن الحقوق والحريات.
We would tell each other when will we see the day that the Yemeni woman would come out, break the shackles, and demand their freedom and integrity.
وكانت الإجابة قريباً إن شاء الله.
And the answer would always be soon, inshallah, God willing.
قبنا الشوارع والطرقات وكنا نهتف مع مجموعة من مهجري الجعاشن ومن ناشط حقوق الإنسان. مجموعة بسيطة كذلك مع النساء كنا نقول صح النوم صح النوم يا صنعاء صح النوم.
We would take to the streets and we would take to the corner alleys and we would be accompanied by a small group of those who were subject to abuse and every day we would say صح النوم صح النوم, which is wake up صنعاء, wake up to this, the need for this new reality.
صح النوم صح النوم يا أحرار صح النوم.
صح النوم يا أحرار, which means wake up those who seek those who seek freedom.
لم يسمع لنا أحد.
There was no one to hear our calls at the time.
لكننا نستمرينا.
But we continued.
لم نستمر فقط من أجل حقوق النساء.
We didn't continue for the rights of women only.
استمرينا من أجل حقوق المواطنة المتساوية.
We continued our fight for the right of equal citizenship.
أقنعنا المجتمع بأننا قادرين على الدفاع عنه.
We convinced society that we were capable of defending its rights.
كان الجنود والعسكر يعتدوا على الشباب وكنا نحميهم نحن النساء.
The soldiers and the security officials and security members of the security apparatus would attack the youth, and we as women would defend them.
أقنعناهم بأننا قادرين وفعلا أخرجناهم من المعتقلات.
And it was true. We succeeded in bailing them out of the detention centers.
وكان السؤال أيضا يأتي متى ستخرج المرأة إلى الشارع لكي تنتزع حقوقها وحقوق وطنها المغصوب.
Despite proving that we could be effective in the fight, we still continued asking when will Yemeni women take to the streets to ask for their rights.
وكان الجواب قريباً.
And the answer would come back again soon.
لم نستسلم. أبداً أبداً.
We never gave up.
استمرنا في الاعتصامات تحولناها من كل ثلاثاء إلى شبه يومية.
We continued in our protests and we upped the frequency from every Tuesday to almost every day.
نمنا في الشارع قبل الربيع العربي.
We slept in the streets before the Arab Spring.
أضربنا على الطعام.
We went on hunger strike. That's the word.
من أجل حقوق الناس. من أجل حق هؤلاء المواطنين الذين تم تهجيرهم من قبل شيخهم الطاغية مواطن الجعاشين.
We went on hunger strike before the Arab Spring. We went on hunger strike for the rights and for the equality of citizens and of the populations that were being sent out of their homes and mistreated by the government.
لم يسمع لنا أحد.
No one heard our calls at the time.
رفعنا شعار بلادي إلى المجد هيا صعدي وثوري بعزم الشباب الأبي. رفعنا هذا الشعار شعار الثورة لأننا علمنا بأنه لن يخرج المرأة إلى الشارع ولن يخرج الرجل إلى الشارع إلا شعار الثورة بأن بلادي إلى المجد هي صعدي وثوري بعزم الشباب الأبي.
So instead we adopted a slogan, and I'm going to ask you to, if you can say it slowly so I can translate it, because the slogan is great and I don't want it to lose its meaning. So بلادي إلى المجد هي
صعدي
صعدي
وثوري بعزم الشباب الأبي
وثوري بعزم الشباب الأبي. Let's see if I can do this. So, O nation, to glory, come on, rise to glory, and revolt with the determination of the youth that refuses to cease its struggle.
هل سمع لنا أحد؟
Did anyone hear our calls?
نعم.
Yes.
بدأت في هذه اللحظة تتكاثر الجموع من حولنا.
In this moment, people started to congregate around us.
وجاءت هدية السماء ثورة تونس.
And we got the gift from the heavens, which was the Tunisian revolution.
الشعب يريد إسقاط النظام.
And the call that the people want to topple the regime.
فتجمع اليمنيون أكثر.
So the Yemenis congregated in greater numbers.
المرأة اليمنية التي كانت ترانا في الشارع من قبل وحيدين امتلكت الجرأة بعد ثورة تونس بأن تخرج إلى الشارع وأن تقود الشارع كذلك.
So the Yemeni women who used to see us alone in the streets now developed the courage to join us and join our struggle.
تم اعتقالي في يوم 22 يناير.
I was arrested on the 22nd of January.
هذا قبل خروج المرأة اليمنية والشباب اليمني إلى الشارع.
This was before Yemeni women and Yemeni youth took to the Yemeni streets.
وكانت هذه أول حادثة اختطاف لامرأة سياسية في اليمن.
This was the first case of abducting political abduction of a woman in Yemen.
علمت وقتها بأنه على الرغم من الغضب الذي ساورني آنذاك إلا أني علمت وقتها بأنه صوتي وصل إلى كل بيت وإلى كل أسرة.
Despite my anger at the time, I realized that my voice had reached every house and every family at that time.
اليوم الثاني خرجت المظاهرات بالمئات والآلاف.
The next day, hundreds and thousands took to the streets.
كنا نحلم ونحن ثلاث نساء نحمل الميكروفون بأن تخرج النساء معنا، واليوم ملايين النساء وملايين الرجال يقودون معركة الحرية والديمقراطية.
There used to be three of us carrying microphones and asking for people to take the streets, and at that time there were thousands and millions of people taking to the streets demanding freedom and liberty.
الآن هناك آلاف النساء من توكل ومن بشرى ومن أفراح.
Now there are thousands of women who are like Tawakkol and Bushra and Afrah.
صديقاتي ياسمين وتفاحة وزينب اللاتي قتلنا وهن يخوضن هذه المعركة خوضناها من أجل الإنسان.
My close friends Yasmin, Tufaha, and Zainab,
نعم.
who lost their lives fighting for the rights and liberties of the other people who took to the streets.
وأثناء معركتهن استطاعوا أن ينتزعوا حقوقهن كنساء.
And during their battle, they succeeded in achieving their rights as women.
الآن المجتمع اليمني مستعد تماماً لأن تقوده النساء ولأن تكون عنوان الدولة القادمة امرأة حتى وإن وصلت إلى رئاسة الجمهورية.
At this point, the Yemeni population and the Yemeni society is now ready. It's at a turning point where it's ready to accept women's engagement in political affairs. And even if in the next stage for women to be involved in the presidential race.
ليس لأن المرأة فقط دافعت من أجل حقوق المرأة فقط ولكن لأنها من أجل أنها دافعت عن حقوق الإنسان.
And this is not because women fought for women's rights, but it's because women in Yemen fought for human rights.
Yeah.